Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about the basics of a JavaScript. So here is the agenda. First, we will see what is a JavaScript and then why you should learn it. And finally, we will understand what are all the different applications of JavaScript and what are the different concepts that you need to learn to master this JavaScript. So what is a JavaScript? A simple definition is a JavaScript is the world's most popular programming language. Okay, we have C programming, we have Python, right? So those are the popular programming languages. Along with this, JavaScript is also one of the most popular. You know, if you ask why JavaScript is popular, because JavaScript is the programming language of the webs, right? In the web development, JavaScript used so much. Most of the websites, you know, 99%, most of the websites, they have to use JavaScript. And it is especially the specialty of JavaScript is web development. Just like every programming language has its own specialty, isn't it? For example, you take C language. It is actually special. C or C++, the specialty of those two is we can write programming for the devices. So we can do embed systems. We can design embed systems with C or C++. Similarly for Python. So Python is also a programming language, but it's more popular for the machine learning. So similarly, right? JavaScript is more popular for the web. So if you want to master web development, if you want to learn web development, and this is one of the must skill that you should have. And JavaScript, it runs on the web browser, right? Almost all the web browsers supports JavaScript. So you can run this JavaScript on any web browser, either it is Chrome, Edge, Firefox, or Mozilla. Any browser will support JavaScript. And it is one of the core front-end technology along with HTML and CSS. As we know that, you know, in web development, there are three core technologies, especially three core front-end technologies, especially. For the front-end part, if you take, there are three core technologies. That is, one is HTML, second is CSS, the third one is a JavaScript. So if you master these three, right, then if you understood these three core concepts, then you can easily become a master in web development. So these three are the basic building blocks for your learning. Now let's see what is the purpose of what is the main use of a JavaScript. Here, let's see that. Here you see these three images, right? We have the HTML, we have the CSS, we have the JavaScript. Now by looking at this image itself, you should have some understanding about the need of a JavaScript. So let me tell you that. First, HTML. So we know that HTML is used to define the contents of web pages. So HTML provides different types of tags, isn't it? It provides a header tag, it provides table tags, it provides a paragraph tag to show the content on the web page, like this. And once you have the HTML, then we have the CSS. What is CSS? It's just a markup kit for your web page. So using CSS, we can apply styles to that content. So let's say if this is your HTML content, then with help of CSS, you know, we can convert this into a beautiful one. So that's the power of CSS. So it's just a markup kit for your web page. So next part is JavaScript. See, by looking at this image itself, we have some understanding. So if you want to perform some action in your web page with the components that we have defined, right? Then we need a JavaScript, simple way. So JavaScript is used to program the behavior of web pages, isn't it? Let's say you have a login form and you have the login button there. So whenever you click on a login button, most of the web pages, right? Whenever you click on any login button, what happens? A pop-up will come and asking you for the username and password, isn't it? So that was defined and developed in HTML and CSS. But whether the pop-up is automatically coming, right? It's some behavior is happening. So that can be achieved with the help of JavaScript. we write a program inside your web page so that whenever you click on that any button, a pop-up will come. So that's the purpose of a JavaScript, in simple words. So let's see why you need to learn. You might have already understood the importance of JavaScript. You might have understood JavaScript is, you know, it is used to program the behavior of the web pages, and you might have understood it is one of the most popular programming language in the world. So these two reasons, you know why you need to learn. But there is a one more reason why you need to learn JavaScript nowadays, right? At this in 2020s, you need to learn JavaScript because a JavaScript can be used as a client-side programming as well as server-side programming as well. So it means that we can use the JavaScript in the client side and also the server side. So let me show an example here. Here you can let's take any website, right? Any website, we can broadly divide them into two parts. One is client, one is server. A client is nothing but what you see on the browser. A server is nothing but what content to show. It will decide, it will generate what content to show on your web page. So sometimes a browser is also, sometimes we also call that as a client. So whenever you try to access any data, what happens? A request will go to the server and your server will process, you know, it will take that request, it will process it, and it will send back the response. So how it will do the process here? Some programming language will be there inside this server. Using some programming language, we will write the logic to process that request and send the response, right? So we will be using programming languages here at the server side. Okay. So let's see a detailed image. Here, this is the front end and this is the back end. We also call client side and the server side. And we can divide broadly server side into two parts again. We have the server and the database where we store all our website information. As we know, how do you develop front end with help of HTML, CSS, JavaScript, isn't it? And let's say you clicked on a login. You entered the username and password, you clicked on login. Then that data, that request will send to your server. Then what your server has to do, your server has to take that request and read the username, password, whatever you entered here. And again, check that against with the database, whether it is right or not. And send the response back. So how do you write all this? How do you process all of that logic using some programming language, isn't it? So that can be done in PHP, that can be done in ASP.NET, that logic can be written in Java or Python as well. Okay. When I was learning JavaScript, I don't have an option to use JavaScript at the server side, right? It is only meant for the client-side programming language. So, but now, right, in 2020s, we can also use JavaScript at the server side as a programming language. How it can be done is with the help of the Node.js. Node.js is not a programming language. It's a runtime environment for the JavaScript. So with help of Node.js, what it does is a request will come back to the Node.js, and in the Node.js, we can write the JavaScript programming. We can write our logic in JavaScript here to perform all our tasks. So that's why I'm saying JavaScript can be used at the client side as well as the server side. This is one of the most important point about JavaScript. So when I was learning web development, I have to learn HTML, CSS, JavaScript, along with at the server side, I have to learn a different programming language altogether. I have to learn PHP or ASP.NET or Java or Python. But now for you know it. If you load JavaScript and if you're using a Node.js at the server side, then simply you don't need to learn a new programming language altogether. You can simply use a JavaScript. So that's the advantage of learning JavaScript. And one more reason here is there are so many useful and powerful JavaScript frameworks and libraries are available for the JavaScript. So let's see some of them. You see Angular, Ember, Backbone.js, jQuery, Meter, React, Node.js. See, this Angular and React, these are the buzzwords right now in the web development. And jQuery, it is used to simplify our JavaScript programming. So there are so many libraries, there are so many frameworks that are built on top of the JavaScript to make our job easier. If you know the JavaScript very well, then you can easily master all these things. You can easily master any framework. You can easily master any library that was built on top of a JavaScript. So that's the second main reason. Now let's see what are the different concepts that we need to learn in JavaScript to master this programming language. So here is a list. First, we will start learning variables and then data types in JavaScript. And then what are the different operators like arithmetic operators, logical operators, and then control flow statements like if statement, if else, and loops, for loop and while loop. And then finally functions, right? Arrays, object. Till here, right? Till here, variables, data type, operators. These till here is common for any programming language. If you learn till objects, then you will have some good understanding about JavaScript. Now it's time to interact with your HTML elements. So in this part, right, interacting with DOM. So we'll learn how to modify the HTML contents, how to access the HTML contents with help of JavaScript. And then we'll see how to handle events. And then we'll see the concept of callback functions, which are very important when you are learning about asynchronous requests. Okay. So finally, right? Finally, ES6 concepts. So these are recently introduced arrow functions and template strings and some oops concepts. So these are really helpful, right? These ES6 concepts are really helpful in Node.js. Let's say you want to use Node.js at the server side, right? Then in the Node.js, we use a lot of this notation. We use arrow functions, we use template strings a lot. You have to be very comfortable with this ES6 notations if you want to learn a Node.js. I think that's all in this session. Let's get started by learning each and every concept in detail. Thank you all. See you in the next session.